What's up, danger? Like, what's up, danger? What's going on, guys? Andrew Sveta here, back with another video. We are back with another video. I'm sorry if I'm talking a little weird. I did cut the inside of my mouth. I fractured a tooth, so if I am talking a little weird today, sorry about that. But the Mets have made another signing, and they finally addressed some starting pitching depth. And the kind of, I guess, the fifth starter for the Mets this season until Noah Syndergaard comes back. And the Mets have finally signed Taijuan Walker to a two-year, $20 million deal with a third-year player option. I think it's like $6.5 million. On a player option, and I've seen a lot of mixed opinions about Taijuan Walker. Some people really like the guy, some people are not a fan, because I think it depends what spectrum of baseball statistics you look at. If you're more of an analytics guy, baseball savant, he does not have a good baseball savant. His hard hit rate, everything is very bad, but I think it's a hard hit rate. I think it was the only thing he had really good in like the 84th percentile, but everything else is low and bad, like 66 or lower. So his baseball savant is really bad. You look at last year, just basic statistics, in 53 and a third innings, 2.7 ERA, 50 strikeouts, and a 4-3 record with split time with Toronto and Seattle. You look at his best, maybe one, I would say his best year in the National League was 2017, went 99 with a 3.49 and 157 in a third inning, struck out 146 batters with a whip of 1.33. He's a career 3.84 ERA, 3.84 ERA, and 581 and two-thirds innings, struck out 528 guys with a 35-34 record. I think a lot of people are seeing this and thinking, oh, he's going to be the number three, and like, it's an overpayment. But really, guys are being overpaid this offseason, so money really isn't a big deal with me, especially that the Mets rotation after next season really only has three guys in Carrasco, DeGrom, and now Taijuan Walker. Obviously, Stroman and Syndergaard are free agents. So at least maybe they give you at least guaranteed to have three starters next year, so you don't have to spend a full rotation. But again, I've seen a lot of people, because I think if you compare Joey Lucchese's baseball savant to Taijuan Walker, Lucchese has a better baseball savant, just like percentiles, like spin rate, all that stuff. Why not have both? So the Mets have both now. Taijuan Walker probably will be the fifth starter. This season behind DeGrom, Cookie, Stroman, Peterson, and now Walker, and then Syndergaard comes in, probably Peterson or Walker go out of the bullpen, and they have extra depth as Jordan Yamamoto, Joey Lucchese, Gian Reed Foley, and they have all the minor league guys that they brought in, like Yennessy Diaz, Sean Reed Foley. So the Mets have brought in some depth, and it's a good move. I would have preferred him over guys like Arrieta, Rich Hill, guys that they were interested in signing, where those guys are over the hill and 35 plus. Walker's 28, so. And I think a lot of people were saying, oh, he's young, he's not hit his prime yet. I think Jacob DeGrom has ruined pitchers, where like, well, you see Jacob DeGrom, he's gotten better at it with age. So I think that's ruining like the pitcher's reputation. Like, oh, we can get a guy who's young, and like he's not going to be himself till 30. Again, it's a good move. It's a number five start. I mean, I could see why you're upset, because you're paying $10 million for a fifth starter. You know, you wouldn't like that. You'd usually probably want to go cheaper, or maybe just some in your system, like a minor leaguer. But the Mets are trying to compete for the playoffs, and you know the Braves have a good 1-5. Now the Mets have a pretty solid 1-5, and then if you get Noah Syndergaard back at any percentage of what Noah Syndergaard is, this is a very dangerous rotation. So bullpen is still a need. I still would love them to sign Shane Green. That's one of the guys who I was really interested in the Mets signing, is Shane Green. He's still out there. Jeremy Jeffries is still out there. So those are two guys maybe keep an eye on for the Mets. For me, I'd love Shane Green. The Mets are also $15 million to luxury tax. I think after this contract, they're at the luxury tax of $195 million. So they still have $15 million if they want to play, but obviously you got to sign Lindor, you got to sign Conforto. So I would love maybe offer like $6, $7 million to Shane Green. That's who I would want, I think, especially missing out Lugo for probably a month or two. You bring in Shane Green with May and Diaz, and then hopefully you get anything out of Betances or Familia if they're not moved. I think they need another reliever, and maybe they make that at the deadline. Maybe that's their deadline acquisition, and maybe that's what their idea is. Maybe not spending big on reliever when you probably trade up at the deadline. So you could see that, but I would like them to add one more arm in the bullpen. They got their depth starter, their fifth starter, and Walker. Now I would like some depth in the bullpen. Shane Green would be the perfect guy for me, but you know, if this is saving the money to pay Lindor, okay. So leave in the comment section down below, what do you guys think of the Taiwan Walker deal? Do you think it, do you like it? Do you love it? Are you on the side of analytics where he sucks? Or are you on the, you know, 28-year-old young upside guy? Leave in the comment section down below, what do you guys think? And be sure to like, comment, subscribe, turn on notification bells. You never miss a mess upload. And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.